started having interest in music in a very early age. What did you listen to then?
Yeah, pretty much everything, from goth to punk to breakdance to hip-hop, everything. I had an older brother, he would come and bring the music, the cassettes, the vinyls or whatever. My parents also had some influence on that because they're listening to a lot of Brazilian music actually, and Portuguese.
You also played on bands.
Well, the first band I played, I was playing drums. And then I moved to some other city to study when I was around 16, I think. And I started playing bass to this Portuguese band, Um Zero Amarelo. And then when I moved to Lisbon, I actually like exchanged places with this bass player on this band called Pop Del Arte. And he went and played to Um Zero Amarelo, and I started playing with Pop Del Arte. Yeah, and then I did my own bands, one called Os Losers and another one called Galatrop. And that was my last thing I did. Galadrop, they're still playing. Now I'm just making music by myself.
How did you cross over into being a DJ?
Actually, I think most of my friends, like the musician people I knew, most of them were DJs too. And this was like early 90s. So it was really easy for me to start DJing because, you know, they were connected. And eventually I met this girl. She was like a big hip-hop DJ. And she had turntables at home and loads of records. And she taught me to mix. And then I developed my own style doing the stuff live.
Tell us about your residency and your long 8 to 9 hour sets.
So I'm resident at this place called Lux in Lisbon, and I've been there since 98 when it opened, so 14 years from now. I'm from a time that there was only one DJ, so it was kind of normal to DJ like 8, 9, you know, whatever hours, and I got used to it. And for me to adapt to do something smaller, I mean, obviously I can do it, but I'd rather do longer sets because it's more what I'm used to do. It's easier for me to do it, actually, to express myself in a way that sometimes when you do like short sets, you don't know the place, and then it's like you don't have enough time, you know, to comprehend whatever is happening.
Let's talk about your releases, DFA, and your label Interzona 13.
I mean, the DFA thing probably brought the name out there, obviously, for sure. But in terms of music, I like every record I did, and you know, you tend to always like the last thing you did. So I started my own label, Interzona 13, so I could have more control of the process, so it tends to be out faster. For the first time, I did a record from an outsider, but I'm not thinking of doing many more. I just do my own stuff, and that's it. We'll be right back.